Alright, we're going on to part 3 of solving linear equations. So, this is another linear equation, but neither side happens to be simplified. When you're solving a linear equation, it's probably easier to begin by simplifying each side. In other words, you might need to combine like terms, you might need to use the distributive property. For this problem, we'll need to combine like terms. So, let's do that. We have 4x minus 1x. Remember, you don't see the 1 there, but 4x minus x is like 4 apples minus an apple. So we've got 3x minus 11. And let's see, over on the right-hand side, I've got 2x. I don't have that anything to combine with that, so I still have 2x. And I have 2 minus 20. Remember, that's 2 minus 20 or 2 plus negative 20. So that's negative 18. Alright, and now we're down to something that looks a little more workable. So I've got x terms on both sides. So we want to remove them from one side by adding the opposite or subtracting it off. So if I have 2x on this side, I could subtract 2x from both sides. And so I'm going to write that under its like term on the other side, which is over here. Alright, now at this point you could go ahead and subtract, or you might notice this. I'm going to get an x over here. I'm going to have an x minus 11, and I'm going to have a negative 18. How about at the same time, we get rid of this minus 11 on this side? So I had minus 11. To undo that, I'll have to add 11 to both sides. All right? So you'll notice on one side of the equation, you could see what's going to drop off. I have a negative 11 and a plus 11. And on the other side, I have a 2x and a minus 2x. You want to, like, have only the variables on one side and constants on the other. So this will just give me x plus 0 or x equals, and what's going to happen over here, I have negative 18 plus 11, which is negative 7. So it gets it down to one step, really, if you do that all at once. And you can take several steps to do this. This is just a technique for doing it one way. In fact, notice what I'm doing is I'm sort of keeping the variables on this side and the constants, C for constants, on that side, and then I'm getting rid of the constants on the left side. I'm getting rid of the variables on the right-hand side. So I'll end up with just with the variable equaling some constant. So I have x equals 7, right? And of course, we want to check and make sure that's correct. So we write down the original problem to check it. 4x minus 11 minus x equals 2 plus 2x minus 20. To check it, remember to write down the original problem, not some intermediate step like 3x minus 11 equals 2x minus 18, because you might have made a mistake on some step in the middle. All right, so we're going to plug in negative 7 for x. So remember, 4x means 4 times negative 7. I'll just do that in parentheses, 4 times negative 7. Minus 11. Now be careful here, you're minusing a negative 7. Don't just put 7, you're subtracting a negative 7. Alright, let's simplify the left-hand side. So 4 times negative 7, remember you have to do multiplication first, is 28 minus 11, and this will be minus a negative 7 is plus 7. And now I could go left to right, or I could add the 28 and 7 first. I'll just go ahead and go left to right. 28 minus 11 is 17 plus 7, so this side is 24. All right, let's see what we get on the other side. We're going to plug in negative 7 for x. So I have 2 plus negative 14 minus 20. So I have 2 plus negative 14 is negative 12, and then minus 20. So that gives me negative 32. That's wrong. So we must have made a mistake someplace. Okay, so before going up and redoing it, I'm just going to look at my check and see if I can find a mistake. And I just found it. 4 times negative 7 should have been negative 28. So there is a problem. Let's do this over. Hopefully, that was the only mistake. So let's see, I've got negative 28 minus 11, that's negative 39, plus 7, whew, that's negative 32, cool. All right, now, So I did actually get the problem right. X equals negative 7 was correct, but when I checked it, it looked like it was wrong. So the first thing you might want to do is just look at your check again to see if you made a quick mistake, which I found. And if you can't find a mistake there, you might need to go back and redo the problem. You might have done the whole problem right. Okay, did any of you catch that before I did? I hope so. All right, so the answer to the problem then is negative 7 is the answer, or negative 7 using the braces. Very easy to make a mistake. That's why we check our answers. All right, here's another one where the left side's not simplified. The right-hand side is, but we have to do the distributive property on the left side. First of all, we have to distribute our negative sign across this one, and then we'll have to add like terms before we can even get started using the addition property of equality. So let's do that. You need to distribute the 5 to the 3 and the n. So that's going to be 15 plus 5n, because 5 times 3 and 5 times n. All right, and then what do we do with this minus sign? Remember, you have to distribute your minus sign by changing signs of whatever inside. So that's going to give you a minus 8n, and it's going to give you a minus 9. And on the right-hand side, we still have the negative 4n. All right, now we need to combine like terms. Well, my two like terms here for the variable parts are 5n and negative 8n. So you have to add those together. 5 minus 8, which is 5 plus negative 8, is negative 3n. And then we're going to add 15 minus 9, which is plus 6. All right, so I've simplified the left-hand side. All right, now we've got some variables on both sides of the equation. You could either put the variables on the left side or the right side. I'm going to go ahead and put it on the left side because I haven't gone over what you're going to do if you end up with a minus sign in front of a variable yet. So let's say we're going to add 4n to both sides so that we have the variables on the left-hand side. And that means we don't want to have this plus 6 hanging out on the left. So how about subtracting 6 from both sides? Now, there is no number over here, is there? So just go ahead and put minus 6. Just notice I'm always doing exactly the same thing on both sides of the equation. I'm adding 4n minus 6 to both sides of the equation. So this gives me just n, because negative 3 plus 4, so that gives me n. I'm just going to write it over here. And this gives me negative 6, just so there's not all that space. So it looks like the answer is negative 6 if we did everything correctly. Now let's check. Now to check, you have to write down the original problem, the big mess. 3 plus n minus parentheses 8n plus 9 equals negative 4n. And here's an important point I want to make. When you are checking your answers, do not use the distributive property. Use the order of operation when you check your answers. So that means simplify inside the parentheses first. There will be no need to use the distributive property because they're just going to be numbers. So I'm going to plug in negative 6, so 3 plus negative 6. And we have 8 times negative 6. And let's just simplify the left-hand side. All right, so what do we do? Order of operations, you simplify inside parentheses first. All right, so we've got 3 plus negative 6 is negative 3. And over here, inside the parentheses, I got to do my multiplication first. So that's negative 48 plus 9. And if I simplify inside parentheses still over here, the negative 48 plus 9, I think that's a negative 39. So it's a negative 39. Okay, and let's go ahead and do the just multiply. 5 times negative 3 is negative 15. So you should get negative 15 minus negative 39, which is negative 15 plus 39. Now you're adding a positive and a negative, so that's going to give you, I think, 24, I hope, if I did my arithmetic right. All right, now what about over on the right-hand side? Remember what we're plugging in for n? We're plugging in negative 6. So I have negative 4 times negative 6. All right, that's 24. Woohoo, yay! Easy to make a mistake when you're checking your answers or doing the original problem, because there are a lot of steps for this one. If you can get through that one, you're doing great. So what you might do is try this problem all over again on your own and see if the way you do it, gives you the same answer as mine. And your check should look pretty much exactly the same as mine. I'm simply doing order of operations. The only thing you might do different is you might not be adding up and down. You might be taking two steps here. Back, look at how I solved it. You might be doing it horizontally instead of vertically. All right, so go on to part four, and we're going to be working with problems where you might have a minus in front of the variable, and how are you going to deal with that? Okay, have a good time. Keep practicing. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.